woman with a future and a past. A little attitude problem, all good, it'll make the shit last.
I am Shakira. Yes, yes. Welcome back to my channel. So it's been a long time coming. Like, this video was supposed to be out from January 1st, like New Year's. New Year's, guys. It is the end of January. It's going to be February. So, like, I've been noticing a lot of persons, they're like, oh my gosh, I need a redo. Like, January, yes, January, the month of January needs to be, like, the free trial. And, like, everything really starts February 1st. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do that as well. Because, like, honestly, like I said, this video was supposed to have been out from January 1st. So February 1st, I got you guys. So from the title of this video, you guys should know what I'm going to be talking about. We're going to be talking about creating and achieving our goals in the year of 2020. I know a lot of persons, their minds are probably not even on this because it's like a lot of things have been happening, like the beginning part, just January alone, like a lot of crazy things have been happening. There was just an earthquake yesterday, crazy. They were talking about a tsunami watch. I was like, oh Jesus, okay. And then there was like Kobe, like, who, if you don't know Kobe, like, honestly, not know Kobe, but if you don't know of Kobe, it's like, man, come from under the rock. Like, whatever the rock is, like, just lift it up because you're missing out. Like, that is a household name. Like, Kobe and his daughter, as well as some of her friends who are on a basketball team and their family, they passed away in a horrible plane crash. Like, January, there's like a lot of crazy things that have been happening, and the year has just started. But honestly, like, a lot of persons, their mind might be like, okay, well, 2020, they're probably not even thinking of it as a year for them anymore. But do not be discouraged by the crazy things that are happening. People are dying. Like, I mean, like, things are happening, like, every day. It's not because it's the new year, January, things aren't gonna happen. Like, it could have happened and in part of last year. Like, seriously, guys. So, don't be discouraged. Do not be discouraged. And, honestly, give me 2020 NT year. Give me 2020 any year. Because, listen to me, 2019 wasn't it for me. 2019 was not it for me. Like, it was just a little too rough. So, honestly, 2020, and yeah. But let's get into it, guys. So, creating and achieving our goals in 2020. My first point is to think about your life. Like, how you want your life to be in the next 5 years, right? So, long-term goals. How you want your life to be in the next 5 years. For me personally, I look at it and I'm like, in the next 5 years, like, coming from my heart, like, I really want to be married with kids, like, traveling at least 2 times a year, really just being able to go out and spend like really quality time with like friends and family and stuff. So when I think about it, when I visualize like how I want to be in the next 5 years, I automatically think, okay, financial stability. And then I also think about like great relationships, like being a person that has built strong relationships over the years. So when you think about your long-term goals, you can make short-term goals, like things that you could do this year that can add up over the years and help you with your long-term goals. So with that, when I think about great relationships, my goal could be to hang out with a friend, or at least hang out with each, I don't know how much friends you got. I don't have a lot, you know what I mean? But for persons who, I guess, don't have a lot, or like, they could manage it however you want to manage it. Your goal could be, okay, well, I want to spend time with people at least once a month or twice a month, like on the weekend or something, like to have like a little date to go someplace. It don't have to be like something expensive. It could be just hanging out on the beach or going to Starbucks or like stuff like that. Just being able to talk and be like, hey, how's your day? Or even just calling them. Like, your goal could be simple as making sure I call each, like, every one of my friends at least once a month just to check up on them to see how they're doing. Like, that could be a goal. Another thing could be, when I think about financial stability, it could be savings. Okay, so I want to save $10,000 this year. So you just want to think about, you want to think about how you want your life to be in the next 5 years, and then make short-term goals based off of your long-term goals. So that's point number one. Point number two is, when you are making your goals, you want to be as realistic as possible, but at the same time you still want to challenge yourself. So when I think about savings, because I think that's for a lot of persons, like everyone's goal, as everyone, when they make lists to say, okay, these are my goals for the year, they have something to say, okay, well, this is the amount that I want to save, right? So savings would be, I think everyone could relate to the savings. So let's say you make $175 a week, right? You might want to, like, I'm not calculating the math in my mind. I didn't pre-calculate this before I started this video, so bear with me, numbers might be a little bit off. So let's say realistically you could save $5,000 within a 6 month time period, right? Now me, like, this works for me. What I do, I give myself a challenge. So if realistically I could save $5,000 and all I really need to save is $5,000 in 6 months, then I would tell myself, okay, my goal is $7,000 in the next 6 months. Because what that does is, now I put more energy, I put more drive, I put more effort into making sure I get to the $7,000 goal mark. But we're human, so at some point you could slip up, you could be like, you know what, I go on a date this week, or I'm going out tonight. Like, you know, we slip up, we're human, you know? So with that, my goal might've been the 7,000, and like, I've been working extra hard for this, you know, starving and saving and just not buying myself anything. And then like, okay, I slip up. But what that does now is, because you gave yourself like a challenge, you now like, when you do slip up, it has a cushion for you now. So at the end of your 6 month mark, you might not have the $7,000, but you might have $6,500. You might have $6,000. You might have, or you might even be the $5,000. That's the number I said originally, $5,000. You might just be to the $5,000 mark. So even though you put all your effort into it in the beginning, because you wanted the 7,000, because you're human, we all fall off. You know, you might just hit the 5,000, the realistic goal that you had initially. And, you know, so that's just what I do. That's just what I do. I like to give myself a challenge that's a little bit far off from the realistic goal, so I might be able to hit the challenge. You know, everybody want the little extra coin, you know, an extra $2,000. Like, crazy. Oh my gosh, 6 months. Ah, you know, so if you don't hit it and you got what was the realistic goal to begin with, you're still happy. You still met your goal. You still met your mark. So that would be my next point. When you create your goals, make sure that they are, think about it realistically, and then still give yourself a challenge. Yeah. Cool. We got it. All right. So number three would be to visualize your goals. So what I love the idea of vision boards. Like, I love the idea of vision boards. Or even if it isn't a vision board, like, you have like a picture frame that's in the front of your bed or on your wall. So when you wake up in the morning, in the picture frame, it has some things that could remind you of your goals. So on my vision board, I would have a picture of two friends holding hands. That's like, okay, work on your relationships. Or I would have a house. Work towards your house, the house that you want. I would have some cash or like a bank or whatever to say, okay, yeah, you need to remember to hold off on the coins that you like to spend, because it needs to go in your bank account. Like, you need to work on saving. So it's really nice to have like that little reminder in the morning, especially in the morning. I feel like that's when you program your brain best to get the things done that you need done. So vision boards are great. Portraits, like a little picture frame that's on the wall, or even if, let's say you don't have time to do a vision board, or, well, you could always make time, but let's say you don't have time to do a vision board or put anything in a picture frame to post up on the wall, you could also have like a daily reminder on your phone that just pops up and be like, hey, remember you're saving a day, hey, You got to call this person today. You know, like something, give yourself something to just piggyback off of, you know? My next point after that would be to have an accountability partner. It's always great to have someone there who is able to say, hey, yeah, Akira, you're slipping up a little bit. Like, honestly, you didn't need to go out. Or when last you call this person, because and you say you're working on relationships, when last you call this person, it's always great to have someone, like, you could even, like, set meetings with, like, every month to be like, hey, how you doing? Like, how's everything going? Because I know you had some goals for the year. How are we going towards that, you know? So an accountability partner, like, I have a person in mind that I love as an accountability partner. She's always been the person like I would use, and she would use me to say, keep each other in check when we used to like talk to each other all the time. But we understand each other. We know that we don't get to talk to each other all the time, but still love her, and I know she still loves me. But like, find yourself that person. And also, when you're looking for an accountability partner, you need to know yourself when you're picking this accountability partner, because it's like, you don't want someone you know is going to be down on you, unless you're someone you need someone to be down on you. Or you don't want someone who's nagging you unless you know you need someone who nags at you. You know, like, know yourself. And then last but not least, believe in yourself and go to God about anything that you want this year. Because at the end of the day, whatever God has for you, that's just it. No one can take that away from you. Like, if that's ready for you, you ask God to do it. We don't have because we don't ask. So go to God and pray whatever you need, whatever you want. Go to God and just be like, hey, God, like, honestly, like, yeah. Yeah. So. Toodles, guys. And I hope this was helpful to anybody. Oh, my gosh, I am late. Woo, gotta go.